Trump just beatdown the backstabbing Twitter employee who killed his account, put him on one-way flight. Several weeks ago, Americans were shocked to find that Twitter had taken down President Trump's Twitter account. The means by which the president communicates with Americans was removed for a short time, and it left people wondering if he was being silenced. Since Twitter is a private company, of course it's their right to take down any account that they wish, but it begs the question, what are they trying to keep quiet? In this case, the account was down for a scant 11 minutes, but it still brought up a lot of questions. The first of which was, who did this and why? As it turns out, Twitter blamed one particular employee, a German national who was, you guessed it, of Middle Eastern descent. Badr Daisk was apparently working on his last day at Twitter before returning to Germany and blames a number of things for the account being taken down: accidents, coincidences, tiredness, and of course, that the people wanted it taken down. Twitter, who is apparently now being run by foreigners, was notified post-haste, and restored the account, but not without arousing a whole lot of attention. According to the Daily Mail, Daisk recently gave to TechCrunch where he talked about his life, post-Twitter/Trump fiasco. It seems safe to say that he greatly regrets the decisions that got him to where he is now. Badr Daisk, a German national of Turkish origin who was employed in Twitter's San Francisco headquarters on a temporary work visa, came forward as the man who briefly silenced the president. While many anti-Trump forces hailed Daisk as a hero for muting the volatile American president and his favorite mode of communication, he claims there was nothing intentional. "It was definitely a mistake," he told TechCrunch. "If I'm involved in this, I really apologize if I hurt anyone. I didn't do anything on purpose. I didn't do any crime or anything evil, but I feel like Pablo Escobar," he added. Daisk says that on his last day at the company, somebody submitted a complaint against Trump for violating Twitter's guidelines that ban users from incendiary comments. The event took place on November 2nd, just before 7 p.m. It's worth noting that the official POTUS account wasn't the one that went down, but the president's personal account that he uses the most frequently. Users searching for that account received an error message and were told that the user does not exist. While that might be some pretty strong wishful thinking on the part of liberals everywhere, we're not to the point of shutting down all contrary thought just yet in this country. Twitter immediately looked into the issue, restored the account, and started pointing fingers. While we might not ever know exactly what happened in the Twitter headquarters that day, we do know exactly what they want us to know. In a tweeted statement, the company said Trump's account was inadvertently deactivated due to human error by one of its employees. "We are continuing to investigate and are taking steps to prevent this from happening again," the statement continued. But in a second statement, Twitter confirmed it was an employee on their last day. "Through our investigation, we have learned that this was done by a Twitter customer support employee who did this on the employee's last day. We are conducting a full internal review." According to the offending employee, the whole problem started because the @RealDonaldTrump account was flagged, and after he performed functions on his computer, corresponding with that flag, it caused the account to be shut down. According to Daisk, he didn't even know that it was shut off until later in the day after he left work. His actions caused many Trump haters to call him a hero, even saying that he should be awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. As for Daisk, the attempt to shut down the president's means of communication with the American people has completely ruined his life. Via the Daily Mail. "I didn't hack anyone, I didn't do anything that I wasn't authorized to do," he said. "I didn't go to any site or tool where I wasn't supposed to be at. I didn't do any crime, and I underline that I complied with all rules." Daisk said that he is unhappy about the notoriety he has gained since November 2nd. He said that since his last day at Twitter, he has been hounded by the press. Reporters have also contacted his friends, who cut ties to Daisk in response. "I just want to continue ordinary life. I don't want to flee from the media," he said. "I want to speak to my neighbors. I want to speak to my friends. I had to delete hundreds of friends from social media, because reporters are stalking me. I had to delete so many pictures and I just want to continue ordinary life. Whether the shutdown was due to this one Turkish employee, or he was just a handy-dandy patsy for the social media giant to put the blame on, either explanation is extremely troubling. Americans deserve to hear from the president anything that he wants to say, and if he's so terrible like they want us to believe, then we will hear it firsthand. But if he's actually working for us, we can get the straight information on that too. Either way, unless you've got something to hide, no one should be afraid for people to hear the facts.